Hi, Emily here from Homemade Emily Jane, and today I'm very excited to share with you everything you need to know about backing a quilt with Minky fabric. I'll start off by sharing a little bit about Minky fabric and where you can get it and the different types and kinds of Minky, and then we'll dive into some tips and tricks to make your quilting a total success when you're backing your quilt. So first off, what is Minky fabric? There are lots of different names people use. Maybe you're using the term cuddle, super soft fabric. It is a knit fabric with some fuzz that makes it super, super soft. There are different kinds as well. Some of them have a very low profile and some have longer pieces as well for a more loft in their fuzz. So I'll share some of my favorite kinds with you right now. The brand that I like to use the most is Shannon Fabrics, and their trademark name is Cuddle. So if you hear someone talk about cuddle fabric, they're talking about specifically the Shannon Fabrics version of Minky, but you can also find Minky fabric at all different types of arts, crafts, and fabric stores as well. I like to use just the basic cuddle fabric from Shannon Fabrics that is like this one here. You'll see it has a super, it's super soft, and you can see the nap to it when you pet it in one direction versus the other. A very low loft makes it super easy to quilt with, and it's just basic, solid, no design. There are other options as well I'd love to share with you a little bit more. A second very common popular version that I also love using is this cuddle dimple. So cuddle dimple has the same loft as the flat one, but has these little dots on it, and it adds just a little extra texture that you can do on the back of your quilt. And of course, there are tons of really cool options as well. So I wanted to share with you, this one I have is this hearts design. So it's that same low loft look, but some pieces have a little higher loft and some have a lower loft to make a design like this one. There are hearts on these. I also have an entire Shannon Fabrics cuddle card to show the entire collection. So they have just regular flat cuddle, and then there's cuddle with the dots, cuddle dimple. And then there's also these designs that they have. There are stars, hearts, this really neat houndstooth design, and all kinds of different options as well. I definitely recommend checking out some of those fun designs too. But as I mentioned, my favorite is just the simple classic cuddle. They call that cuddle 3. So I assume that they might have had different versions in the past, but this color card that I have is from 2019. So there are some possibilities for changes, but you'll see on this first page there are so many different colors. So I love shopping in person, but of course if I'm not able to shop in person, finding a color card like this to have at home is super great for online shopping, so I can make sure to find the exact color that I'm looking for. So a color card like this has been super helpful. Traditionally, most Minky fabric you'll find is in a 58 inch wide fabric, so a little bit wider than your classic quilting cotton, but it's not always wide enough to back a throw size quilt. So for instance, the quilt behind me is actually 58 inches wide, so using fabric that's 58 inches wide would be cutting it super close and is not recommended. So for instances like that, I highly recommend checking out the Shannon Fabrics Cuddle Wide version. It's actually closer to 90 inches. The wide cuddle fabric is actually 88 inches wide, which would actually be pretty ideal for most throw size and some bed size quilts. So if you want to not have to piece your quilt back at all, the wide cuddle is one of my favorites. Now, a lot of the tips I'm going to share throughout this video are for if you're planning to quilt your quilt on your own machine at home. I would love to also invite you to contact your long arm quilter. There's a good chance that your long arm quilter is willing and able to quilt your quilt on their long arm machine, regardless of the quilt backing, such as Minky. So check out your local long arm quilter and see if that's something that they're comfortable doing. That's a great option as well. Most of the time, it's really not all that different for a long arm quilter, but because the Minky fabric does stretch a bit, you wanna make sure that it's something that they've tried before and that they're comfortable doing. There is a common misconception that working with cuddle or Minky fabric is very challenging and difficult, and I'm here to say that it's really not. as far as backing a quilt with it, I do the same steps and the same process and the same techniques that I do when I'm using cotton fabric. I will say it's just a little bit stretchier and slides around a little bit easier. But if you are comfortable backing a quilt with cotton, I think it's time to take on the challenge and see how it goes. One of the most frustrating parts about working with Minky fabric is that it does shed quite a bit when you're cutting it, especially if you're using the higher loft pieces like the Luxe Cuddle. So if you're using Minky fabric, I highly recommend keeping a small vacuum nearby and maybe a lint roller for your clothing, because those little tiny pieces do kind of go everywhere and I like to try to keep my room as tidy as possible. I've also seen this hack on Instagram recently, so it's worth trying, but some people like to place a piece of painter's tape right where they're planning to cut and then cut on the tape, cutting through the tape, so that that tape then collects all of those extra little particles and they don't go flying everywhere. So I would love if you could try that out and let me know how it goes for you. I personally just make sure to keep a little handheld vacuum close by and vacuum after every cut. One question I get asked quite often is whether or not I use batting when backing my quilt with Minky fabric, and the answer is yes. I've done it before where I don't use batting, and it makes for a very thin quilt, but even here in Florida where it gets pretty hot, I like batting in between my quilt top and my Minky fabric, but I do like to use a more lightweight batting. I highly recommend using a blend such as like a bamboo batting blend, something that's lightweight and won't bog it down too much, but of course if you're in a colder climate as well, any kind of batting would be great to give it a little extra cozy and warmth. Another very common question that I receive is whether or not to pre-wash your fabrics if you're using Minky. So the main difference between using Minky fabric as backing and your classic quilter's cotton as fabric for your backing is that cotton will shrink when you wash it and dry it, but Minky is made out of polyester, which is a synthetic material, and it won't shrink in the same way that cotton does. But even with that information, I still do not pre-wash any of my fabrics if I'm making a quilt. So I don't necessarily worry about that shrinkage all that much. I think it just makes for a super cuddly quilt in the end. If you do want to minimize your crinkle in your quilt, then my best recommendation would be to pre-wash all of your fabrics. With the exception of batting, you never want to wash the batting because it can disintegrate, but you would be able to put that batting in the dryer with a damp washcloth and let that tumble dry for maybe 20 or 30 minutes, and that'll get the wrinkles out of the batting for you. And then begin that little drying process for a little bit of shrinkage that might come out of it. So once you've picked out your Minky fabric and your batting that you're going to use, the next step will be to baste the layers of your quilt together. So you'll grab your quilt top, your batting, and your backing, and you'll get ready to baste. My biggest advice if you're backing your quilt with Minky is to make sure that you're using a spray adhesive, and then I also come in through with some pins just to make sure that everything stays in place. Basting it well is incredibly important for getting rid of any puckers in the backing of your quilt. So I highly recommend basting it very thoroughly, and I actually have a complete tutorial all about how to baste your quilt with spray adhesive. You can check that out right here, and you'll actually see that in that video I am using Minky fabric. There are lots of different spray adhesives that you can use. This is one of my personal favorites lately because I'm able to get it in these giant cans. The can will last a handful of quilts, and it's super easy to use. Just make sure that you follow the safety instructions. It's nice to have some open air flow when you're using the spray because you don't want to be breathing that in. And as I mentioned, after doing the spray adhesive, I do like to come in through with a light layer of pins just to make sure that nothing shifts as I move that quilt that's basted over to begin the quilting process. Now the next step is to quilt your quilt. Using a walking foot is super helpful and very important for any kind of quilting, and it's one of my quilting secret weapons. I'd love to invite you to check out my 3 quilting hacks for straight line quilting. You can find that one right here. That'll give you some tips and tricks for your quilting process that apply no matter what kind of fabric you're using on the back of your quilt. When you begin quilting, you'll want to start towards the middle of your quilt and then work your way outwards. That would help eliminate any shifting that might occur. I also find it easy to baste along one edge of the quilt before I actually start and then use that as my starting point. So for instance, I would baste along the top edge of the quilt and then begin doing straight lines down from that top edge and then rotate the quilt if needed and do the opposite side in the same manner. Once you get all of the quilting done, the final step for making your quilt and backing it with Minky will be adding your binding. Because the Minky fabric does take up just a little bit more room than your quilting cotton in the binding, I do recommend increasing the size of your binding strips just a little bit. So I use 2.5-inch strips for my binding, and I use that no matter what type of backing I'm using, but I do kind of pay close attention to where that fabric is when I flip it over. If you need help with your binding, you're in the right place. I actually have 3 articles up on my website to walk you through every step of binding your quilt. I'll link all 3 articles down below. The first one will walk you through how to prep your quilt for binding and how to make the binding. That is super important, and it involves some steps that people sometimes skip, but I promise you, if you follow all the steps, it does make attaching your binding a little easier. The second part of the 3-part series is all about machine binding and how to sew that binding onto your quilt using your sewing machine. And then finally, the 3rd part of my binding series is about hand sewing the binding onto the back of your quilt. That step is totally optional, but it is some people's favorite step. I'll give a little disclaimer. If you're using Minky fabric, that hand sewing part does get a little bit more tricky, but it's actually a lot easier to hide any stitches that maybe aren't as perfect. So I recommend trying it out and seeing what you think. I hope you loved learning about how to back your quilt with Minky in this video. If you have any questions, I would love to hear them. Make sure that you leave a comment down below. Let me know if you've ever backed your quilt with Minky and if you liked it or not. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Make sure you check out homemadeemilyjane.com for lots more quilting tips, tricks, and techniques. Happy sewing!